Presiding Officer, the widespread and clearly expressed concerns that have been raised across the country about the SNP's proposals to raise substantial parts of our most commercially successful parts of Scotland's national forests need to be brought to this chamber urgently. These contracts will last for decades. They will deprive the Forestry Commission and 18 future Scottish governments the revenue from forests planted at a public expense, and in the process will damage the ability of the Forestry Commission to manage the strategic change needed in our forests. I want to put on record, we are not opposed to all the suggestions made by the Minister. Indeed, the proposal to enable the Forestry Commission to enter into joint renewables ventures to plant more forests is one which was in our manifesto. We strongly support that. But we are opposed to the main proposals as set out in the policy and financial memoranda attached to the Climate Change Bill that I have mentioned. They are ill thought out, they lack a published business plan, and despite a series of questions on fundamental aspects of these proposals, no substantive answers have been given. It is unacceptable that ministers who have had 22 months to work up proposals for this bill have at the 11th hour suggested these major leasing proposals, as people in the industry have put it to us, a bolt from the blue. The Rural and Environment Committee will be put in an unacceptable position. In 2 weeks, in one brief session, they will be expected to consider the implications of these huge proposals without seeing the full results of the hurried consultation put together at the last minute. The consultation closed this Tuesday. We waited till then so that people could pass us their comments. We will not see a full report of that consultation. Ministers themselves will not see a full report of that consultation until the end of February, we're told by Spice, and the responses won't be made available to everybody until March. And whenever we've asked questions, we've been told, oh, you're scaremongering, you're being deeply misleading. Yet we have referred back to the initial consultation document, which gives no detailed information whatsoever. The Minister keeps attempting to reassure people by saying, these are just ideas, just proposals. Yet in the financial memorandum to the bill, it's absolutely clear that it is intended to secure powers through the bill to allow by secondary legislation the release of capital from the National Forest Estate for the letting of timber cutting rights. And the memo is clear. It is a 75-year lease over 100,000 hectares, up to 25% of the National Forest Estate. But the document is very, very vague about the income. It could be an upfront payment, or it could be an income stream, a pretty basic issue to pin down at the start. Without guarantees, this is money up for grabs by a cash-strapped government. These proposals would see the SNP borrowing from the future. It would take at least 2 years for a lease to be even drawn up. And if you take a conservative estimate of the steady income stream to the Forestry Commission, £10 to £15 million in today's money, we're talking a million of £750 million loss for a paltry income of £200 million, maybe, where there aren't the plans to spend it. The sums simply don't add up. It's a bad deal for Scotland, but a really good deal for one lucky, possibly private investor. These proposals are a damaging diversion from the debates we should be having on the other parts of the Climate Change Bill. We're concerned about biodiversity, the promotion of access, the loss of jobs, particularly in fragile rural areas. Understandably, forestry workers are deeply concerned about jobs, but they're also concerned about the integrity of the Forestry Commission and the sustainability of Scottish forestry for the years to come. They are not reassured by the Minister about their jobs. Many of them work in our most remote rural areas, and they understand employment law and the financial imperatives of one single employer wanting to recoup the money they've paid up front as fast as possible. Industries who rely on the long-term contracts managed by the Forestry Commission are also deeply concerned. Even when wood prices drop, they know they have long-term contracts with the Forestry Commission with a steady stream of wood. And they see these proposals as causing irreparable damage and causing jobs. The sawmill sector are made up of successful Scottish family businesses. They want to expand, but they're worried about the implications of one big company coming in and vertically integrating the whole operation. And it's not just the processors. Climate change means we need more wood for our sustainable construction industry. The renewables industry also needs more wood for local supply. There's no point developing local biomass plants if the wood pellets are imported and our existing Scottish wood is exported abroad. That's what the Forestry Commission can guarantee us now. That would be lost. and environmental NGOs are worried about the loss of biodiversity and the strategic management and experience that the Forestry Commission bring to our forests. They'd rather the Forestry Commission was focusing on other challenges, like the stewardship of our peat bogs, vital if we're to tackle climate change. And there must be a coherent land use strategy underpinning forestry expansion. The right tree, in the right place, at the right time. We've got mountain biking facilities which would simply not have been developed without the long-term partnership, investment and expertise from the Forestry Commission. And multi-use forests are there in the public interest. We must not damage that going forward. These plans do not add up. They are deeply unpopular. The forestry unions have already generated over 3,000 signatories. Our own petition has over 800 responses. People have put their views out strongly. Let me quote one comment from our website. As a lifelong member of the SNP, I am appalled and embarrassed by this proposal. If money is needed to fund an extra 100,000 hectares of new plantations, it should come from the Carbon Emission Reduction Programme, funded by energy utilities, who are major CO2 polluters, and not from a flawed, irresponsible, uncosted adventure to privatise our greatest national sustainable asset, i.e. our land and all that grows on it. Our motion asks for these plans to be dropped now. They're deeply damaging to jobs, not just in the future, but now. We're in a deeply difficult financial situation nationally. The last thing this government should be doing is to make that worse. There are alternatives. Let's focus on them. Sorting out the rural development plan, less than £1 million from the Woodland Challenge funds out of £14 million allocated so far this year. That's not good enough. Look at the new revenue streams from renewables. Look at community participation. The SNP government must do the right thing. Dump these unpopular, ill-thought-out, damaging proposals. Let us focus on the way forward. I move the motion in my name.